name is Todd Hurst. I am a cardiologist who specializes in the prevention of heart disease. Welcome to Your Health Questions Answered. Do statins really cause muscle pain in some people? This has been a debate in medicine for some time, but a recent study provides helpful information that settles the issue. Before we get started, I will emphasize that this information is for educational purposes only and is not medical advice. Don't make any decisions about your medical treatment without first talking to your doctor. Statins are among the most prescribed medications, with millions of people taking them worldwide. Since statins first started being prescribed in the 1980s, doctors have recognized that about 10% of people taking a statin will complain about muscle pains. It is also known that statins can cause a very serious breakdown of muscle called rhabdomyolysis, which is fortunately very rare and typically associated with other medications that interact with a statin. However, most people with muscle pains on statins don't have any lab testing abnormalities and no way to determine if the muscle pain is being caused by the statin or something else. And research hasn't been that helpful. Most randomized trials have shown that muscle pain is about the same in the placebo and statin groups. However, these studies typically also had what is called a run-in phase, where all subjects were given a statin for a period of time, and if they had side effects, they were excluded from the trial. So while researchers have debated whether statins really caused muscle aches or not, clinicians and the patients who had muscle pains on statins are convinced that the symptoms are from statins. Who's right? I think this study provides the answer. So in this study, about 500 patients who were deemed statin intolerant, that means that they were not able to take three different statins due to muscle aches, were randomized to taking a statin or placebo. They didn't know which one they were on. But then this study did something really interesting. They switched them. So to be clear, every patient in this study took 10 weeks of either a statin or a placebo, and then after a two-week washout period, they took 10 weeks of the opposite. The point of the trial was if most of the patients had muscle pain on the statin, then the statin was the problem. If an equal amount had symptoms on the placebo, the statin wasn't the problem. And here are the results. About 43% of the patients got it right, meaning they had muscle aches on the statin but were able to take the placebo. About 27% got it exactly wrong, meaning they could take the statin but not the placebo. 10% had muscle aching on both the statin and the placebo, and 17% had no problem on either the statin or the placebo. So what does this mean? I think this trial shows us two things. One, statins do cause muscle pains in some people. But number two, some people think they have muscle pains on statins, but it's not the statin that's causing their symptoms. If you are trying to decide if taking a statin would be right for you, download my free guide, Should I Take a Statin? This gives a balanced view of the risks and benefits of taking statin medications so that you can make the right decision for your goals. There is a link below this video. So now you know that muscle pains caused by statins is real, but there are also a lot of people that have muscle pains that are not being caused by their statin. In my next video, I will talk about my strategy with my patients to help sort out who has true intolerance to statin and who doesn't. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, hit the like button below, share it with your friends and family, and be sure to subscribe. I would love to connect with you on Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest, or Instagram, and you can join my better health community at toddhurstmd.com, where we talk about your better health, better life, and better weight loss.